And I've got my colleague Deepak with me. So we both represent Intech Infonet. It's a Delhi-based company. And we are the system integrators for the leading OEM, which is Cisco, which everybody knows about it. So we are a leading system integrator for them in terms of doing a lot of work in the education side, primarily in IITs. So today we are going to present in terms of, see, you must have heard a lot of presentations from all the OEMs out there, okay, and who are the original technology providers out there. But then this technology has to be implemented, it has to be implemented in the right direction, the customer has to be partnered in terms of what is the roadmap with this technology is going to have over a period of time. So that's what we are going to focus upon, and the experiences which we had, well, we have deployed all these solutions from OEM like Cisco in those campuses. We are going to discuss few things about that, and also we will cover up some part of it, like security as a technology, how it's going to really help, and how it has been currently deployed, and what the roadmap is going to be there. So that also we're going to talk about. So I'll, without wasting time, I'm going to put through to Deepak, who's going to run through this entire thing presentation out there.
So, good evening, everyone. My name is Deepak Kaul. I am from Intech Infonet, and I represent the system engineering division of Intech Infonet. And as rightly sir has already led the scope for this presentation, OEMs have already come here and given the presentation on what technology is going forward, what is happening in the technology side, and where we are moving forward on this. So my primary focus would be for the campus networking, what challenges a campus like IIT, NIITs and Central Universities face, because all these technologies like IoT and AI, so for this underlying network, basic network, wireless, the security around wireless, the security around wired is of primary importance. So firstly, I would brief about what Intech is. Maybe some of you know us, maybe some of you don't know. We are the system integrators from Delhi, based out of Delhi, and we are 25 years old system integrators, and we have been doing system integration in a lot of campus and leading big central universities. So these are the key offerings what Intech has, and we, as rightly said by sir, that we are partners with the leading OEMs like Cisco for the Active, Ruckus. We are partners with CommScope for the passive part, because these are the underlying components which are basic for a high powered network, and going forward to IoTs and doing the artificial intelligence. So it's data networking, enterprise routing switching, application load balancing, for the network security, firewalls, AAAs, and security management, and then it's unified communication, IP telephony, video conferencing, wireless, the campus wide wireless, which every campus is right now wants to have. No campus is complete without a wireless network. So, and of course with the proliferation of the mobile devices, and we need surveillance, physical surveillance around the campus. So since IoT is in picture, and the CCTVs which were earlier analog now are on to IP, so since everything is going on to IP, which we call IoT now, so these are the key components which a campus should have. So these are the software division of Intech, and these are the offerings which have on the application basis. So IT consultancy, application services, software development if any app is to be developed, and enterprise application like job referral portals and single sign on and project delivery. So we do all these things because these are very much needed for a deployment of a campus network, because the project timelines, what is happening, because there is a dependency when you deploy, because we have vast experience in delivering the technology which OEM discusses, so that has to be seamlessly given to a and deployed properly in a campus. So project delivery, what are the dependencies for active digging, all these things are very much, you know, a part of that campus network. So since we are gold partners, so we are having advanced collaboration, that is the IP telephony, video conferencing, the certifications, data center, security, enterprise, which is consists of routing, switching, and unified computing, the UCS, the Cisco compute. So we are ISO 27000, 2000 and 9000 certified. We are also CMMI level certified system integrators. So these are the education. I am not because since we are in the education campus right now, I didn't want to put, you know, clientele which are not relevant to this presentation. So these are the few big names in the education vertical where we have deployed a substantial amount of yeah.
AMU, when did you did the work?
AMU
must be more than 4 year old, isn't it?
Yeah.
More than 4 years.
So since Aligarh AMU is a prestigious university, so that has to be put here. It's so in IIT Delhi, so a lot of system integrators are there who, you know, say IIT, we are, you know, present in every sphere of verticals. But why I have put these slides is because the substantial work and what we have done, that is why I have put this slide, so that this shows that how much of work and what kind of work we have done in these institutes. So like for example, IIT Delhi, we have deployed more than 400 access points. There is NMS running. We are is the first installation of GPON, Cisco GPON, in I guess Asia. It's the first deployment of GPON. So 1360 GPON OLTs and ONTs are deployed, which are running in this campus right now. More than 8000 nodes, Nexus core. This is the, there are 160 blade servers which have been deployed in this network. So this is IIT Roorkee. The deployment is going on. The passive deployment is going on. We have just got this order, and it's more than 350 switches, 8,000 plus nodes, 2,500 plus access points, NMS, complete suite of Cisco umbrella security from endpoint to the OpenDNS and Cisco unified with VC and video conferencing. So IP phones, wireless, spread across residential areas, hostels. We have also done the networking for IIT BHU, which is almost complete now, almost complete. So Molex was the passive component, Fortinet, Cisco, complete switching, wireless, Nexus 9K access switches, wireless controllers have been deployed in this network.
So, this SSM integrator actually takes after the OEM sells the technology, which has been sold in a lot of cases, which has been already nominated So system integrator, one who actually understands the nitty-gritty of the business, where the technology, how it can be deployed out there. And what is the roadmap which the customer should take? If I see all these slides which have been actually presented out there, and also the slide which has been, which is already there reflecting out for IIT BHU, if you can just put it out there.
Yeah.
So you can see a lot of components which are there, which goes into a LAN infrastructure, which has a campus, where the campus gets all these products and technologies they want. What is that is going to help the campus, the institute, and what is the roadmap they should take it after that? They should, in current scenario and going forward as well, the campuses are turning into smart campuses. So in those smart campuses, what is that smart campus we talk about as a system integrator? Our thinking is that we are going to build this campus, which includes all the basic infrastructure, whether it is LAN infrastructure, top of the switching, whether it is passive part of it, whether it is voice part of it, whether it is video part of it. Now, how you are going to integrate seamlessly all these components put together, and how it's going to really benefit from an application perspective, how they are going to apply all these products in their main line of work, which an education should is imparting the education, whether it is giving into the classroom, which is within the campus, or it's streaming outside otherwise. So that is what we are actually communicating, that you have put all these infrastructures currently. How you are going to turn it from this level to the next level? That's what I think this message is coming out, that these slides are, that the first level has been already covered up. We should, and we are already looking at, because we have worked with few IITs out there who are thinking on those terms, where it has to be taken from one level to the other level. I think Deepak is presenting all these things, but the roadmap is going to be the smart campus out there. And he's going to present two slides on that.
So, typical components of smart network are LAN infrastructure, management, Wi-Fi, video surveillance, video collaboration, secured access, how you are, the security around the network, you have the visibility of who is getting into the network, what an individual is doing with the network, how they are using it, seamless roaming, high speed network, there's a NOC center, and there is BYOD, because like I said, with the proliferation of the smart devices, many people bring different kind of mobile devices, and how they come onto the network and how seamlessly they integrate with the current network and they work seamlessly. So key challenges, what we have found, you know, during the deployment of these networks. So what are the management we are using, the scalability of that network, increasing bandwidth need, because students are, you know, getting on board, more and more students are getting on board with more and more devices, so increasing bandwidth, interoperability with the devices, because it you know, networks are now heterogeneous, so how they are interoperable with each other, how the investment is being protected. I mean, you have deployed lot of security and lot of these things, so how is it is being used? So unstructured network, you know, lot of different kind of switches or Wi-Fi devices have been put onto the network over the course of time, and you don't have complete visibility of those devices. So, and seamless roaming, how, because if you are putting, like, let's say different devices, how a person is going to seamlessly, let's say he is roaming from one building to another, so one building has set of other Wi-Fi network, one, so how they seamlessly roam from one building to the other. So these are the network challenges which we have seen.
So once can you just turn it back?
So I'm just interrupting in between so that at least we get communicative with yourself, with your thought process. These are the challenges which we have seen that this campuses face. Whether it is unstructured network, which Deepak actually explained, in terms of there is so much of heterogeneous environments which are going into those campuses. Are we bringing them together? Are we trying to bring them together so that we have a seamless network out there? The wired network is there, the wireless network is there, the voice is there, video is there. How we are really trying to collaborate everything put together out there? Those pieces out there, I would say. So we should be very careful in terms of going forward. We should partners like the system integrators, we should really have those thought processes going, and also involve the OEM. So we all should sit together in terms of to understand how we are going to put these pieces together to make those campuses, which we call it, whether you call it smart campuses or digitally transformed campuses. I think these things are very important in terms of going forward. So these are the challenges which really will, if we address those challenges, it's going to cover all these points out there.
So if you can see, these are the real pictures which we have taken during the deployment of the campuses. This is the unstructured cabling. So we are talking about IoTs and all those things. So the basic infrastructure has to be there, and I mean structured in a structure, be it a passive network or an active network, it has to be in a structured manner, so that all these, you know, top up technologies like IoT, wireless, unified communication, VC, high definition, smart classrooms, and all those things. Because if you, I mean, these are bandwidth hungry applications. So if this is the kind of a structure which we have, the basic structure. So they would not be, you know, very useful, and they will not work, you know, the way it should be working. So this is the same thing I have, you know, explained: unstructured passive networks, restrictive backbone. Somewhere it, some people have done it for 10G. Some area of the campus is only running on 100 Mbps. Somewhere it's UTP. Somewhere it's OFC. So there's no, you know, structured manner of, you know, that network. So it's not scalable, and seamless wireless coverage is not there. Analog phones are running; they are not interoperable with the IP phones, and VC solution is running silo. So these are the, how the guest is getting on board. So all these things, you know, these are the challenges which, with these technologies, what OEM is talking about. And if we, you know, deploy it in a structured and in a proper manner, so we can mitigate all these challenges, and we can have a smart campus running. So this is the, one of the structures which we have, you know, provided, and you know, it's a design for a logical diagram of a campus network, the underlying infrastructure. So on top of that, this you can see, you know, the NMS is running, and everything is in a structured manner. The high availability has been taken care in the campus. The ISP, from the ISP level to the routing to the switching, and everything you can see from the top end to the bottom. So everything is in a structured manner. So this is one of the examples, like code distribution, it's running on 10G. From distribution to access, it's running on 1G. Or maybe it's running on 10G and distribution to core is running on 40G. So this is the kind of a typical network architecture for a campus. So to address the challenges like load balancers, three-tier architecture with core distribution access layer. So these, what we mean by this slide is that the underlying network infrastructure is there for the smart campus to.
Okay, just for the 5-10 minutes, I just want to just explain this slide out.
Time
okay.
Is running out.
Just 2 minutes, so I'll take
4 minutes.
Yeah, 4 minutes. No problem. So I think this is the last slide we are coming. So I just wanted to sum this up and conclude with this particular thing. So what we have actually gathered from this entire thing, and what he was, Deepak was trying to explain, is that architecture has to be robust, it has to be logical, it has to be structured. Any network which we are going to design for the campus, which is going to be smart campus going forward, the roadmap. Okay, that is the first point. Second point is in terms of any OEM which we are going to consider has to be in terms of all these components which we have talked about, or which are going to be positioned, which are going to get associated with our business line, has to be seamlessly talking to each other. That is the another one, which has to be open and has to be covering all the phases, all the components which are part of the network. And third and foremost, which I've seen digital transformation, we are talking about applications, we are talking about digitally transformed, but nobody is talking about secure digital transformation. So security is going to be paramount going forward from here. Okay, secure, if we are not able to secure our network, which is the information, if we are not going to secure our, users, the devices which are going to be present into the network, because any user can come into the network through your wire or wireless network, any user can pump in any information out there, okay, with any of the devices out there. So all these things, if we are not going to take care from a security perspective, we need to have a security. We have been talking about piecemeal, we have been talking about components by components security, but nobody is talking about the complete architecture. As an OEM, we are just trying to say that let's talk about the complete architecture. I think that is covered up, and anything which needs to be discussed, we are there. Offline, we can always discuss. Thank you very much for your patient hearing.
And I have just 2 minutes of, I think we have 1 minute. Yeah, so I have a smart campus sample, like what. So this is what we are talking about with.
Smart campus strategy is an ambitious integration plan based on the Internet of Things. to comprehensively digitise, decommission physical cameras. And the primary aim is to create enriched, personalised experiences for students as they move around our physical campuses.
So library occupancy heat map came from a solution that students indicated that if they actually knew the number of students within the library, they may have a better idea of whether their preferred study spaces within the library were occupied or unoccupied. Students can actually pan and move a map within the library and toggle between a heat map and a cluster map. Extensively use Cisco wireless products throughout the university here. Cisco themselves provide a solution called the Relay Service Manager, which is location-based tracking, which shows students exactly how busy each of their individual areas of the library. It utilizes the wireless access points.
Access points within that area, and we can triangulate position from there. The concept originally came from interactive workshops, students and library staff here at the university. Those workshops were very interactive. The students actually worked on drawing, designing and prototyping some solutions to the problems that they might face on a day-to-day basis.
So at Deakin, we're justly proud of our number one ranking for student satisfaction in Victoria for 6 years in a row. So we don't just want a campus that has operational efficiencies that automatically controls temperature or lighting or unlocks doors. We want a campus that is context and location aware, that knows who you are, where you are, what you need at any given point in time, and delivers richly personalised experiences to you.
The Assist Me app also came out of some interactive workshops that we ran. We know that students often need quick help with something when they're studying in the middle of the library, such as finding a particular piece of study material. But it can be somewhat disruptive to their study to have to walk all the way to the information desk and maybe queue up. And once they're set up, it's actually quite awkward for them to leave all their stuff behind. So we're prototyping an app that lets them request instant help, like booking a library tour, a study room, accessing a database, or finding a book. This sends an instant notification to the library staff. It uses a location technology to show staff where in the library help is needed, and it's personalised to show who exactly needs the help and what they look like. The staff can then go directly to the student in need, quickly resolve their problem, and allow the student to continue their study with minimum disruption. We're looking to do a wide range of things with Cisco and with their proximity and locational based services. We think it's a great platform. Through the Deakin Sync platform, we're starting to understand a lot of student preference. By adding the extra context in of where students are on campus, we're going to potentially be able to provide a lot of innovative services for students.